Hello and welcome to Skill Builders. This is a tutorial concerning the installation of Solaris kernel zones. Zones are an integrated part of the Solaris operating system, which is owned and developed by Oracle. Both Solaris 10 and Solaris 11 support zones, which up till now have been very lightweight virtual machines, using the same kernel as is running on the host system, known as the global zone. These are also sometimes referred to as containers. However, since Solaris 11.2, kernel zones have been available, which allows you to run independent versions of the operating system with their own kernel within the global zone. Okay. And this is the first time this has been possible, so you can maintain zones at a different software level, different patch level if you like, okay, along with other facilities such as the ability to suspend them and resume them perhaps on the same or a different machine, so you can migrate kernel zones, assuming you can allocate shared storage between systems. You do need fairly up-to-date hardware, fairly powerful hardware to support this. Okay, in terms of Spark servers, which are another Oracle product line, you need anything between a T4 and a T7 or M7. Note the firmware revisions that are detailed on this page. You can also run kernel zones on Intel architecture, assuming that the resources are sufficient, and you would need to make sure that the BIOS stroke EFI has CPU virtualization enabled. Okay. You also need a fair amount of RAM, and a minimum of 8 gigabytes is recommended for the host system, or global zone if you like. You do need a software package installed, which we can see on the right hand side. Let me introduce you to a Solaris 11.3 system called Buzz. Solaris 11.3 is the latest version of the Oracle Solaris software. I'm logged in as root, which some of you may argue against, but of course, you know, if your best practice is to use sudo, then you can use that. Okay, so let's have a look at make sure the package is installed. There we can see the output from the package list command, and if you look over to the right hand side, note the information under the IFO heading. I in that first column means that the package is installed. Okay. If it were not, then if you look on the left hand side, you can do the package install brand Solaris KZ command to install it. Okay. You may also want to check to make sure that your system actually does support kernel zones, and the way to do that is to type vert info. Okay. And there we can see non-global zones are supported, which are the normal, if you like, run-of-the-mill zones, and kernel zones are supported as well. Okay. If that doesn't come out, then you cannot install and use kernel zones. Okay. Note how the example on the bottom of the left-hand page there shows that you can even run kernel zones on a VMware guest running Solaris 11, 11.2 or 3, but you need to enable nested virtual machines within your ESXi VMware host. You may also need to do a bit of tweaking with the Solaris memory management to limit the size of something called the ZFS ARC cache. The ARC cache is a way of caching read data from disk in memory, and it's called the adaptive replacement or adaptive responsive cache. Okay. And it uses a lot of free memory to be as efficient as possible, which theoretically it will free up if something else requires it. It might be an issue, however, at the speed with which the memory is actually freed up, so you might have to set a kernel parameter, which I'll show you towards the end of the section rather than getting involved in it now. Now let's begin configuring our kernel zone over on Buzz here, and we would use the zone cfg command to do that, which might be familiar to some of you who have configured ordinary zones in the past. I'm going to call this zone KZone1.
the option correct. When I do create minus T, that's specifying a type of zone. Normally, for a run-of-the-mill zone, I just type create. This is known as a branded zone, so it's a little bit out of the ordinary, and it's called a Solaris KZ zone. Now, there's very little, in fact, required to configure the zone. Believe it or not, that's all I need to do. I could use other parameters, for example, to specify alternative storage, to specify additional resource controls like RAM and like CPU, and other things. But just to create a basic kernel zone, that's all you need to do. Okay. And by default, if you look down on the slide here on the left-hand side, I'm using Solaris 11.3. Okay. And that, by default, will give a template size of 4 virtual CPUs and 4 gigs of RAM. Okay. Instead of doing sys-solaris KZ, I could in fact do sys-solaris KZ minimal, which will cut things down to 1 vCPU and 1 gig of RAM. Also, the system will use a ZFS emulated volume. Okay. For more information on that, then have a look at the Solaris documentation. And it will use a ZFS emulated volume by default as its disk device, which will set to 18 gigs. Again, that can be changed. And I'll give you an example very shortly. Okay.